Boxing trainer Robert Garcia is a household name to millions of boxing fans. They watch him on HBO, on Showtime, on pay-per-view cards, working the corner of some of the sport's biggest names, like Brandon Rios, Nonito Donaire, and Antonio Margarito, just to name a few. But it's not the fact that he's a former world champion himself that makes him a good trainer, nor is it the fact that he has great boxing knowledge. It's his personality. Check it out. What are you selling?
Hey, you
candy
change?
Bars for the Christian Center.
To keep kids off the street?
Yes,
Robert,
sir.
It's 8 for $20, dude. I bought, give it $20.
We're from Living Word.
What is that?
That's a Duck Christian, that's a church.
Uh-huh.
And we're from Living Proof Training Centers, where we reach, teach, mend, and send.
That one?
How do you know they're not going to buy crack cocaine in like 20 seconds?
Huh? More likely they will, but we got some candy.
We did what we were supposed to do. They said it was to help kids, so that's what I do.
Help kids?
But what they do with their money is their business. That's on them.
I thought she was on meth.
She probably was.
Mike's in great shape. Mike's always been in
Garcia, who's considered by many the best trainer in boxing, was just nominated by Sports Illustrated as Trainer of the Year 2011. But when you sit down with Robert and his grandmother, you'll find out that she doesn't even know what he does for a living.
You know, Robert is very popular. He's big in the boxing world.
She don't know all this shit, bro. ¿Usted sabe lo que yo?
¿Qué? ¿Usted sabe
lo que yo hago?
Allí
fue poco más o menos. ¿Qué dice?
Maybe.
Como que a ver, ¿qué es lo que hago? A few bad things, but she don't want to talk about it.
Robert picked up his boxing skills from his father Eduardo, known as the Big G. But while Robert is very easygoing, his father was a very strict trainer. ¿Cómo estás?
Bien.
Bien, how's Mikey looking?
Bien, míralo ahí.
Go look.
Look at Big G. He's stripping on you.
He's asking him, how's Mikey looking? He's there, go look at him.
He burned your ass.
He burned you, Ellie.
See, Ellie, we fuck with you. You don't fuck with a Big G. You don't like him stupid questions. You don't ask for those kind of stupid questions.
You know what he told me once? That you called him when your house was surrounded by cops, that you're like, yeah, Robert, I need money for bail.
Hey, boo, I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna get arrested right now. The house is surrounded, remember?
I don't know, I called him, I go, hey, Robert, my house is surrounded right now. The cops are gonna get me. I'm gonna be able to go back. So tell Cameron I'm not gonna be able to fight, and I'm not gonna go back because I'm gonna be in jail. And so he goes, why, what happened? I'm like, if you want more questions, bail me out, and, you know, send my mom money and bail me out of jail. And you know what? And he did it. And not one or twice, three times he bailed me out of jail. And you know, I paid him back everything, but he bailed me out. That's how I know that he was good people.
And now you're on top of the world. Robert, what have you learned from your dad?
Everything. Everything. How to think, how to get into your fighters' heads and know them mentally, physically. You got to learn all that. You know, I learned everything from him. He's a person I've always learned from, and I still keep learning from him. I still call him for advice. I still call him to tell me what he thinks. You know, he still helps me out on every single one of my fighters.
He's very strict as a trainer.
Very strict.
You're very relaxed.
Yes.
You smile.
Yes.
How do you explain that?
Well, that's probably why, because I was fighting and he was training me, and it was always hard training.
So we're here inside the van of the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy.
Manny Pacquiao, the other day on my Twitter. He tweeted me and he told me, hey, I just want to wish you good luck. He wished me good luck.
I already know
it was
him.
Congratulations, Manny Brandon. Pacquiao on Twitter. I don't know if it was his Manny Pacquiao.
Being a high-profile trainer, Garcia got the opportunity to work with Kim Kardashian when she participated in a charity boxing event.
Very sad.
Wait, you were the one that wrapped your hands in the episode where they had that fucking...
No way!
That was me, fool!
What the
no,
fuck,
that
fucking idiot. What a... No way, fool. I would've got him.
What do you think about her marriage that ended after 60 days, Robert?
It already ended?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
No.
I don't know. Well, I don't
what did you think
TV?
About that?
Damn, that shit was crazy.
Can you make Kim Kardashian into a boxer, into a fighter?
No, I could make her my wife if she wants. Now that she's divorced? Now that she's divorced? Fuck
yeah,
you.
Why not?
So what would you tell Robert Garcia?
Good luck with that, dude.
Every day, Robert Garcia goes to work at his boxing academy in Oxnard, and more than often, other trainers from all over the nation come to train. This is Max Garcia. He's from Salinas, California, about 7 hours away, and he brought his star fighter, Eloy Perez, to train at Robert's gym as they're preparing for a big HBO fight.
Right?
Who? Who's that?
Mr. Clean.
Max.
No, Max looks like the guy from Monopoly.
Like this, Mr. Clean, huh?
Yep.
Monopoly, huh?
The Monopoly guy, damn!
You said that one time, remember?
Yeah, no, I remember Mr. Clean, I was
good. Monopoly guy.
Yeah, that was good. Go collect. Please explain it that you didn't go Hollywood, because so many people that I do meet that have been successful, they change. They leave their past, they leave the neighborhood. You could live right now in Beverly Hills in a luxurious home, just living life, working with the superstar athletes, making a lot of money. Yet you chose to stay in Oxnard, where life is not always easy, where you could have your home broken into, where people do shoot at you. Not at you personally, but I'm just saying it's rough.
Well, I already had my house broken in last year, July of last year, they broke into my house. And I have been shot at too, Ellie, so don't say it hasn't been me. I've been shot at.
But you haven't left, you stayed here, and you're helping the community, you're helping the kids.
This is where I'm from, you know, this is where I grew up. I've been in Oxnard since I was 2 years old. I know Oxnard, I love Oxnard.
Well, what do you think Robert Garcia means to Oxnard, to the city?
Getting kids off the street, future for a lot of kids, man, you know what I mean?
Why the future? Why did everybody tell me that?
You know what? He stayed in the game, you know, and he's coming back, you know, he just didn't take off and get a, you know, left the city or whatever.
Garcia welcomes everyone to his gym. He doesn't judge them whether they have a criminal record. Nestor, what does this gym mean to you?
It's like home. It's like family here.
What happened?
On parole, man.
You got your parole?
Yeah.
What would you tell your kids about that?
Scared of trouble, so what happened to you? Yeah.
Look, he's smoking and he's drinking iced tea.
Oh, yeah.
You shouldn't smoke. It's bad for you.
I know.
Holy shit! How the fuck?
And just, and just 99 cents.
A ver, levántale.
How the orale? Hey, where the water is in that?
We're just people that are down to earth, you know, and Robert is just, you know, Robert is Robert. Robert is Robert, that's how he's gonna be until he dies. He's not gonna change. He's not gonna let the fame, and if he does try to change, get a little rich, I'll bitch slap him. I'll fucking make him come back down to earth. Because, you know, that's not his style. Robert is Robert, and that's what he is.
From the Robert Garcia Boxing Academy in Oxnard, for ES News reporting, I'm Ellie Stackback reporting.